Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Alhamdulillahi rabbil alamin wassalatu wassalamu ala sayyidil anbiya'i wal mursalin wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in. A'udhu billahi minash shaytanir rajim. Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Was-samaa'i dhatil buruj. Today we have Suratul Buruj. Suratul Buruj, Surah number 85. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَالسَّمَاءِ ذَاتِ الْبُرُوجِ وَالْيَوْمِ الْمَوْعُودِ وَشَاهِدٍ وَمَشْهُودِ قُتِلَ أَصْحَابُ الْأُخْدُودِ النَّارِ ذَاتِ الْوَقُودِ إِذْ هُمْ عَلَيْهَا قُعُودٌ وَهُمْ عَلَى مَا يَفْعَلُونَ بِالْمُؤْمِنِينَ شُهُودٌ وَمَا نَقَمُوا مِنْهُمْ إِلَّا أَنْ يُؤْمِنُوا بِاللَّهِ الْعَزِيزِ الْحَمِيدِ الَّذِي لَهُ مُلْكُ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ وَاللَّهُ عَلَى كُلِّ شَيْءٍ شَهِيدٌ إِنَّ الَّذِينَ فَتَنُوا الْمُؤْمِنِينَ وَالْمُؤْمِنَاتِ ثُمَّ لَمْ يَتُوبُوا فَلَهُمْ عَذَابُ جَهَنَّمَ وَلَهُمْ عَذَابُ الْحَرِيقِ إِنَّ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَعَمِلُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ لَهُمْ جَنَّاتٌ تَجْرِي مِنْ تَحْتِهَا الْأَنْهَارُ ذَلِكَ الْفَوْزُ الْكَبِيرُ إِنَّ بَطْشَ رَبِّكَ لَشَدِيدٌ إِنَّهُ هُوَ يُبْدِئُ وَيُعِيدُ وَهُوَ الْغَفُورُ الْوَدُودُ ذُو الْعَرْشِ الْمَجِيدِ فَعَّالٌ لِمَا يُرِيدُ هل أتاك حديث الجنود فرعون وثمود بل الذين كفروا في تكذيب والله من ورائهم محيط بل هو قرآن مجيد في لوح محفوظ. سورة البروج, سورة نمبر 85. The surah takes its name from the first verse where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَالسَّمَاءِ ذَاتِ الْبُرُوجِ. Al-Buruj is the plural of Burjun, and Burj in Arabic means qala'ah or fort, any fort. Baraja yabruju in Arabic means, literally it means to appear. Wahara, something that appears. Or al-burj means a place which is elevated, which is a high place, and it has some people to look after that, like watchmen or some other people who watch over the place. That is also called as al-buruj. It here in the verse where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَالسَّمَاءِ ذَاتِ الْبُرُوجِ, by the heaven holding the buruj or of the buruj. So here it may refer to the doors of the heavens or the biggest stars that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has decorated the heavens with them. وَالسَّمَاءِ ذَاتِ الْبُرُوجِ. In the surah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala swears by the sama, by the heaven, and the day of resurrection, and Friday, and the day of Arafah. And after swearing these important things, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions about Ashab al-Ukhdud. Allah says that they are cursed. قُتِلَ أَصْحَابُ الْأُخْدُودِ. Who were the people of Ukhdud? Ukhdud means ditch. The ditch that you dig in the earth, that is Ukhdud. And أَصْحَاب الْأُخْدُود, the people of the ditch. Here Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala actually gives reference to the people of the ditch. And the story has been mentioned by several Mufassireen, and also Muhaddithin have mentioned in their collections, like Imam Ahmad rahmatullahi alayhi has recorded a hadith that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam has mentioned a long hadith, and in the hadith Allah's Messenger sallallahu alayhi wasallam mentioned about Ashabul Ukhdud, the people of the ditch. They were the people in Yemen. And the story goes like this, that in Yemen, among the people who came before you, there was a king who had a sorcerer. There was a king, and he had a sorcerer, a person who could play magic, who could do magic. And when the sorcerer became old, he said to the king, "I have become old and my time is nearly over, so please send me a boy whom I can teach magic." The king ordered a boy for the magician so that the boy can come to the magician and then he can learn, could learn magic. So he sent him a boy and sorcerer taught him magic. Whenever the boy went to the sorcerer, he sat with a monk who was on the way and listened to his speech and admired him. Like he went, when he used to go to the sorcerer, there, on the way there was a monk. The boy used to sit with him and talk about. So when he went to the sorcerer, one day he passed by the monk and sat there with him. And on visiting the sorcerer would thrash or beat him, beat the boy. Maybe because of different reasons, he would be late or something like that. So the boy complained about this to the monk. The monk said to him, "Whenever of the sorcerer, say to him, my people kept me busy, and whenever you are afraid of my people, say to them, the sorcerer kept me busy." So the boy carried on like that for some time. Then a huge terrible animal appeared on the road on the in front of the people, and people could not cross the road. And this news spread among the people that there is a huge animal and it is on the way and people can't cross through that. This the boy was informed about that, and the boy said that, "Today let me experience what knowledge I have. Today I shall know whether the sorcerer is better or the monk is better." That one, on one side there is a sorcerer who is teaching me magic, and the other hand there is a monk who is teaching me other things. So let me see who is better. So he took a stone, the boy took a stone and threw that stone towards the animal, and that action killed the animal, that creature. That, and then people were able to pass the road. The boy came to the monk and informed him about it. The monk said to him, "Oh my son, today you are better than when he killed the animal, that creature." He came to the monk and informed him about that killing, like that action which he did to the creature. And then the monk admired him. He said, "You are better than I, and you have achieved what I see. You will be put in trial, and in case you are put in trial, do not inform them about me." The monk said to the boy. The boy used to treat the people suffering from congenital blindness, leprosy, and other diseases. And there was a courtier of the king who had become blind. Like, because of the knowledge the boy had, he used to treat blindness, leprosy, and some other disease. And at the court, there was a person who became blind, and he heard about the boy. He brought a lot of gifts for the boy, and he offered those gifts to the boy, and then told him, or asked him, requested him to treat him from his blindness. The boy said, "I do not cure anybody. It is only Allah who cures people. So if you believe in Allah and supplicate to Him, He will cure you." So he believed in and supplicated to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and Allah cured the person at the court, like who was a courtier. Later, the courtier came to the king and sat at the place where he used to sit before. And the king said, "Who gave you back your sight?" The courtier replied, "My lord." The king then said, I did, The courtier said, "No, my lord and your lord is Allah." The king said, "Do you have another lord beside me?" The courtier said, "Yes, your lord and my lord is Allah." The king tortured him and did not stop until he told him about the boy, that there is a boy who has the knowledge of treating blindness and leprosy and other disease. So he tore, the boy brought was brought to the king. And then he said to him, "Oh boy, has your magic reached to the extent that you can cure these disease, blindness, leprosy, and all these disease?" He said, "No, I do not cure anyone. Only Allah can cure." The boy answered. Then the king said, "Me, like the Lord is me?" The king said. The boy said, "No, you are not the king." Then the king asked him, "Do you have another Lord beside me?" The boy answered, "My Lord and your Lord is Allah." So he tortured him until he told about the monk. Then the monk was brought to the king, and the king said to him, "Abandon your religion." The monk refused to do so. The king ordered a saw to be brought, which was placed in the middle of his head, and he fell, sawn into two. Then it was said to the man who used to be blind, "Abandon your religion." He refused to do so, and then the same thing, the same action was repeated to the courtier too. Then a saw was brought and placed in the middle of his head, and he fell down, and then he died. Then the boy was brought, and it was said to him, "Abandon your religion." He refused, and so the king sent him to the top of such and such mountain with some people. He told the people that when you go up on the top of the mountain, you throw him from the mountain. He told the people, "Ascend up the mountain with him until he reach the its peak. Then see if he abandons his religion. Otherwise, throw him from the top." They took him away, and when they ascended to the top, he said, "Oh Allah, save me from them by any means that you wish." The boy said this. So the mountain shook and they all fell down, and the boy came back walking to the king. The king said, "What did your companions, the people I sent with you, do?" The boy said, "Allah saved me from them." So the king ordered some people to take the boy on a boat to the middle of the sea, saying, if he renounces his religion, if he quits his religion, well and good, but if he refuses, then drown him. So they took him out to the sea and said, "Oh Allah." The boy said then, "Oh Allah, save me from them by any means that you wish." So they were all drawn in the sea, and the boy was saved by the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then the boy returned to the king, and the king asked him, "What did your companions do?" The boy replied, "Allah saved me from them." Then he said to the king, "You will not be able to kill me until you do as I order you. And if you do so as I order you, you will be able to kill me." The king asked, "And what is that?" The boy said, "Gather the people in one elevated in a high place and tie me to the trunk of a tree. Then take an arrow from my quiver and say, 'In the name of Allah, the Lord of the boy.' If you do this, you will be able to kill me." So he did this, and placing an arrow in the bow, he shot it, saying, "In the name of Allah, the Lord of the boy." The arrow hit the boy in the temple, and the boy placed his hand over the arrow wound and died. The people proclaimed, then they shouted and they said, "We believe in the Lord." And when they saw this thing, that they shot him with an arrow with the name of Allah, and then he died, then they proclaimed, "We believed in the Lord of the boy." Then it was said to the king, "Do you see what was happened? What happened? That which you feared has taken place. By Allah, all the people have believed in the Lord of the boy." So he ordered that ditches be dug at the entrance of the roads, and it was done, and fires were kindled in them. Then the king said, "Whoever abandons his religion, let him go, and whoever does not, throw him into the fire." And they were struggling and trampling in the fire until a woman and her baby whom she was breastfeeding came, and it was as if she was being somewhat hesitant of falling into the fire. So her baby said to her, "Be patient, mother, for verily you are following the truth." This is the hadith which Imam Ahmad rahmatullahi alayhi has recorded in his Musnad. In the hadith, Allah's Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam talk about those Ashabul Ukhdud, the people of the ditch, that the kuffar at that time who used to believe in the king, they dug the ditches for those people who believed in the Lord of the boy, and it was Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Qutila Ashabul Ukhdud. In this verse, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala refers that story, that cursed were the people of the ditch who dug the ditches for the believers. Ashabul Ukhdud, An-Nari Dhatil Waqood, Idhum Alayha Qu'ud. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in this surah mentions, when he talks about Ashabul Ukhdud, that they were witnessing what was happening with the believers. They were sitting there in their chairs when people were being burned in the fire, in the ditches, and they were witnessing. Also, some mufassirin have explained this ayah, وَهُمْ عَلَى مَا يَفْعَلُونَ بِالْمُؤْمِنِينَ شُهُودٌ, that when they were sitting there and watching what was happening with those believers, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala was helping those believers. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala took their souls from their bodies and protected them, while the fire came out from the ditches and burned all the people who were sitting around those ditches. Or in the day of resurrection, they will be witnessing that they committed this crime, that they burned those believers. They were burning all those believers just because they used to believe in Allah, in the oneness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, who is our Lord, who is the Lord of everything, and in His hands is the kingdom of the heaven and the earth, and He is powerful over everything, and He is witness over everything. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that those who put the believers into trials, and then they do not repent to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, for them will be severe punishment in the hereafter. Jahannam has been prepared for such people. But those who believed and they performed good deeds, for them will be Jannah in the hereafter. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is very powerful. His punishment is severe, and His scissor is severe, and that He will seize all those people with His punishment on the day of resurrection. He creates creatures, He creates all things, and He will repeat the creation of human beings on the day of resurrection. He is most merciful, oft forgiving. He loves all those people who follow His commands, and He does whatever He wills. And then at the end of the surah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given an indication of the story of people of Fir'aun and Thamud, that how prophets came to them and then they belied them, they did not believe in them, they did not accept the message what they brought from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and as a result they were destroyed in this worldly life. That the people of Fir'aun, they were drowned, and about the people of Thamud, that asayha came from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, a huge cry came, and then they were all destroyed, and they were destroyed because they refused to believe in them, in the message of Allah. Subhanahu wa ta'ala has full knowledge of everything. His knowledge encompasses of everything. He knows what is happening, when and what. And this Quran, which is in front of you, is the book of Allah. O believers, you must follow the commands of Allah, and O Kuffar of Quraysh, that you people are denying the message of Allah. You see what happened to people of the ditch, and what happened to the people of Fir'aun and Thamud. If you disbelieve in Allah and you do not accept the message of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then you will be seized with the punishment from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Start the surah, Suratul Buruj, was-samaa'i dhatil buruj. Allah swears by the heaven, holding the biggest stars on the heaven of the buruj. Wal-yawmil maw'ud, and by the promised day. And the promised day is the day of resurrection. You have been promised by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that you will meet this day and you will see this day with your own eyes, and then you will see the result of your doings. Wa shahid wa mashhud, and by the witnessing day, wa shahid. And here it refers the day of Jumu'ah, Yawmul Jumu'ah, Friday. Or shahid, any person who gives shahada, who witnesses for truth or with his truthfulness. Wa mashhud, and by the witness day, and that is the day of Arafah, the ninth of Dhul Hijjah, which will be coming inshallah after a few weeks. Qutila ashabul ukhdud, after swearing, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, Qutila ashabul ukhdud, cursed were the people of the ditch. And here the lesson for us here, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling, O Kuffar of Quraysh, you will be cursed and you will be destroyed as the people of the ditch were cursed, or they were destroyed. If you disbelieve in Allah, if you disbelieve in the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Qutila ashabul ukhdud, cursed were the people of the ditch. An-nari dhatil waqood, the ditch of fire fed with fuel. Idh hum alayha qu'ud, when they sat by it, they were sitting around the fire and watching those people who were being burned. Wa hum ala ma yaf'aluna bil mu'minin shuhud, and they witnessed what they were doing against the believers. They witnessed what they were doing, they were burning them in those ditches. Or they were witnessing what was happening with those believers, that Allah took their souls out of their body and Allah saved them, and the fire came out of those ditches and burned those disbelievers. So they are witness over that. وَهُمْ عَلَى مَا يَفْعَلُونَ بِالْمُؤْمِنِينَ شُهُودٌ. Also Allah, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will gather them on the day of resurrection, they will give this witness. They will be witnessing that, yes, they committed this crime in this worldly life with the believers. وَمَا نَقَمُوا مِنْهُمْ إِلَّا أَن يُؤْمِنُوا بِاللَّهِ الْعَزِيزِ الْحَمِيدِ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that they had no fault, that the believers were being burned, and they had no fault except that they believed in Allah. It was their fault. The Almighty, worthy of all praise. الَّذِي لَهُ مُلْكُ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ وَاللَّهُ عَلَىٰ كُلِّ شَيْءٍ شَهِيدٍ. To whom belongs the dominion, the kingdom of السَّمَاوَات, of the heavens, and الْأَرْضِ, the kingdom and the dominion of the earth. وَاللَّهُ عَلَىٰ كُلِّ شَيْءٍ شَهِيدٍ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is witness over everything. إِنَّ الَّذِينَ فَتَنُوا الْمُؤْمِنِينَ وَالْمُؤْمِنَاتِ ثُمَّ لَمْ يَتُوبُوا فَلَهُمْ عَذَابُ جَهَنَّمْ وَلَهُمْ عَذَابُ الْحَرِيقِ. Verily those who put into trial the believing men and women, and believing women, by torturing them or by burning them as the people of the ditch did with the believers, and then do not turn in repentance to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, ثُمَّ لَمْ يَتُوبُوا فَلَهُمْ عَذَابُ جَهَنَّمْ, then they will have the torment of hell, and they will have the punishment of the burning fire. Here is a warning of all those people who try to torture or burn or put believers into trials, that for them is a warning if they do not repent to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, if they do not turn in repentance to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that they will have severe punishment from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, here as well as in the hereafter. Innal ladhina amanu, verily those who believe. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is consoling all those people who are being burned by those disbelievers or who are put into trials. And it is for every day. It's not just in the case of those people of the ditch that they burn, and those people of ditch were destroyed or they were cursed, and Allah saved those believers. It is for every day that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is consoling, that if they are put into trials and they are tortured, they are burned, they are harmed, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is with them if they are true in their belief. إِنَّ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَعَمِلُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ, verily those who believe and do righteous good deeds, for them will be لَهُمْ جَنَّاتٌ, gardens, تَجْرِي مِنْ تَحْتِهَا الْأَنْهَارِ, under which rivers flow, ذَلِكَ الْفَوْزُ الْكَبِيرُ, and that is the great success. إِنَّ بَطْشَ رَبِّكَ لَشَدِيدٌ, and a warning for those disbelievers who were harming believers, that Allah says, إِنَّ بَطْشَ رَبِّكَ لَشَدِيدٌ, verily, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the scissor, the punishment of your Lord is severe and painful. إِنَّهُ هُوَ يُبْدِئُ وَيُعِيدُ, verily, it is He who begins and وَيُعِيدُ, and it is He who repeats, who begins the creation of things, that He created you first, and then He will recreate you at the day, on the day of resurrection. Or innahu huwa yubdi wa yu'id, here it means that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the one who punishes those disbelievers who harm believers, and then He will repeat this punishment on the day of resurrection. Wa huwa al-ghafur al-wadud, and for those who turn to Allah in repentance, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is oft forgiving. They should remember this, and He is full of love towards the pious who are real true believers in the message of Allah. Dhul arshil majid, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the owner of the throne, the glorious. Fa'alul lima yurid, He is the doer of whatsoever He intends, whatever He wills, He does it. Hal ataka hadithul junood, Fir'aun wa Thamud, has the story reached you of the host? Athhabul junood, hadithul junood, the story of the host. The story of the armies of the Fir'aun and Thamud. Of Fir'aun, Fir'aun wa Thamud. Balil ladhina kafaru fi takdhib, nay, the disbelievers, fi takdhib, they persisted in denying the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and in denying the glorious Quran, the verses which Allah's Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam brought from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Balil ladhina kafaru fi takdhib, wallahu min waraihim muhit, Allah encompasses them from behind. Whatever they are doing, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has full knowledge of their deeds. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will requite them for their deeds, whatever they have done in this worldly life. Bal huwa Qur'anun Majid, they are denying this Qur'an. They don't believe in this, while it is the Qur'an of Allah. It is the word of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It is protected by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Fi lawhim mahfuz, that it is inscribed in al-lawhul mahfuz, the preserved tablet. This is the end of Suratul Buruj. Next surah is Suratul Tariq. Inshallah, next week we'll start Suratul Tariq. Jazakumullah khairan.